Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we inform for lesson 18 and the topic is livestock production 6 and the subtopic is raising of the young stock. On to the lesson objectives. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to state any three types of calf pen, and number two, explain the requirement of a calf pen. Onto the types of pens, we have three types of calf pen. We have raised permanent calf pen. You can see in on the first diagram, you can construct it using timber. And the second type is permanent calf pen with concrete floor. And therefore, the first one, it has just a floor which is made up of wood. But the second one, it has a permanent concrete floor. Then we have the third one, we have mobile calf. Mobile calf, you can see it has wheels, and therefore it can be moved from one position to another. We will look at the requirements of a calf pen. And the first requirement of a calf pen is cleanliness. The calf pen should be easy to clean. And therefore, that's why we are saying that it should have a concrete floor, because a concrete floor is easily washed. And therefore, when it comes to matters of cleaning, it becomes very much easier. Then another one, it should, the aspect of dryness and warmth should be looked at, because if there is cold in the calf pen, the calf will suffer from pneumonia. Then we have the third aspect that you are supposed to consider, that is the requirement number three, should be spacious or adequate space. The calf pen should have adequate space to allow the room for exercise. Because exercise is very, very vital during growth and development for the when the calf is growing. Then we have proper lighting. It should allow enough light to get into the calf pen, and you know the light is very, very vital when it comes to acquisition of vitamin D, and therefore so that the animal can have can be boosted on health as far as vitamin D is concerned. It should allow enough light to get into the house. Then we have the proper drainage. The calf pen should have a proper drainage which will prevent stagnation of water in the calf, and because the stagnation of water will result to accumulation of the disease causing microorganism, and therefore exposing the calf to various infection. Then we have, it should be a drought free. The side which is allowing the wind to come in should be blocked permanently, so that it will be free from disease spreading, because if it will allow the drought to come, the drought is the one which will bring the disease causing microorganism, because it is an agent of transfer, that is a cold weed. Once the cold weed blow into the house, the calf is highly susceptible to more infection. Then we have proper ventilation. When I say proper ventilation, I mean that the calf pen should allow free circulation of air, because you know air is very, very important during the animal life, because it facilitates the gaseous exchange and also the process of respiration, whereby the oxygen is taken in to be used during oxidation of food for the energy to be produced. Then a single housing is also a requirement. The calves should not be put two calves in the same room, and the reason why the two calves should not be placed in a single room is because it will encourage the leaking, the one calf leaking the other calf, and therefore they may end up swallowing balls of air, and therefore which will upset the digestion. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I will will mark the end of this lesson by giving you assignment. And the first question is, you are supposed to state any three types of cuff pen. And the second question, you are supposed to explain any five requirement of a cuff pen. Then for reference, you can refer from the secondary agriculture student book form, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, if you'd like to clarify something from us, you can reach us at LMTV using the following addresses. The first one, that is SMS, using that number which is well displayed for you. You can as well as use YouTube and Facebook platform, and finally you can use the Twitter, where you will reach us at @LMTV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, goodbye.